Hello, this is OS with me, Divya Arya. We sit here every weekday in the middle of the newsroom to bring you the stories as they come into us here. Live pictures have been streamed onto the screens here into the newsroom from Jerusalem, where world leaders are attending a forum to mark the 75th anniversary of the liberation of the Auschwitz death camp. The focus of the event is on fighting anti-Semitism, and we'll be joined by some Jewish people in the next 15 minutes to understand their life experiences. And we continue focusing on the coronavirus, and let me bring you some of the news lines from our live page on BBC Online. That's our website, which has been running a live page for many hours now with the updates as they're coming in. We now know 17 people have died from the coronavirus that emerged in the Chinese city of Wuhan, forcing some cities, including Wuhan, into a lockdown now. There are more than 600 cases confirmed. Those are infected people. Countries around the world have announced they will be screening travelers as suspected cases of the virus are being found or suspected in several other countries. And that list has been increasing throughout the day today. I'm being joined now by our China media analyst, Kerry Allen, who's been our guide through this week. Trying to understand, helping us understand what's being said on social media, which you keenly monitor, Kerry, and some amazing videos and pictures on our live page, which are all coming from social media about how people are being quarantined. What's been happening? Just bring us up to speed.
Yeah, well, obviously, because the city's in lockdown, there's a lot of question about what is actually happening, you know, the only way to communicate this is via social media. And Sina Weibo, Chinese platform like Twitter or Facebook, there's a lot of different videos and images appearing. And, I mean, some of the ones we've seen today, for example, we've seen reporters within Wuhan going to train stations where there is people temporarily can't travel, talking to people who say they didn't have any notification of this, so you know their travel's been suspended and they're really surprised. We've also been hearing about cinemas that have been closed and films that are delaying their film releases because they don't want people gathering in confined spaces. I mean, that's just in Wuhan. We've also the cinemas actually has gone nationwide, but also a number of events outside of Wuhan where people might gather, say parades and big fireworks ceremonies. These are being cancelled as well because China wants to encourage people not to be in huge crowds just in case this virus can spread all around the country.
And Chinese authorities have come under a lot of criticism, it seems. Someone we spoke to in Wuhan was saying that information isn't being given out in time, also alleging that cases appeared weeks earlier than is being admitted. Do you get a sense of that conversation on social media as well?
Well, the very surprising thing today is that actually in state media, a lot of criticisms are starting to come out. So what normally happens is Chinese media will not want to point to criticisms of how could something like this would have happened. There is still, you know, there are propaganda campaigns talking about the positives and how hard health care workers are doing. But we're also seeing a lot of commentaries in important newspapers. I mean, one newspaper is asking today, why didn't Wuhan close the city earlier? This is the Chengdu Business Daily. And also a very influential figure, Hu Xijin, who's the editor of a prominent newspaper, the Global Times, has been talking about how there's a failure to contain this virus. And he's saying that while some might be attaching great importance to, say, meetings and slogans, i.e. these, come on, Wuhan, you know, well done our medical professionals for working so hard, they've not really been mobilised to deal with a large public health battle. So statements like this from big senior, you know, state-affiliated journalists will be embarrassing to the government.
Our China media analyst, Kerry Allen.